Hello and welcome to Kimber Bushcrafts. Nice to see you. There's an old saying that says you have to be careful what you wish. And for me, that was true this weekend. I had planned to go out to my camp and prepare my setup up there, but as you see in my drone footage, that the weather has changed. So we have winter now and a lot of snow. Yesterday, Saturday, when I was out and looking at the camp, I could see there was too much snow, so I could work there. We had about 10 centimeters of snow, and today, Sunday, they say there will be additional 20 centimeters. So they are talking about a snowstorm. Well, I don't know, perhaps. The winter came as I wished, but it was not good for me when I was going out and preparing my camp. So I hope next weekend the snow will be gone and I can come out to my base camp and start preparing the ground for my lavu tents and my fire pits. We'll see. The weather forecast says that will turn into rain later this week and the snow will disappear. But these times, well, it's hard to predict about the weather. You all know that. But in the last video, I promised you I would tell you a little bit about this little hatchet or axe, and that I'm going to do right now. So hang on.
Yeah, and one of the reasons why I bought this little axe is because it had a great story. The company Øyo is located in Norway, up in a little town called Geilo, a place I've been many times before. It's a nice little place for winter sports too. The company has made axes since 1882, and for a long time it was the only factory in Norway that made axes or hatchets. So they have a long tradition, and they are a company with great pride in the handcrafts. For some time ago, they found an old axe in the ground near to the factory, and it turned out to be an old Viking axe, 1,000 years old, and they made a replica of that. And this is a tribute. You can see the sheet here. It is made of felt and leather, and of course I customized it a little bit. This leather was very light brown. I didn't like that, so I dyed it dark brown. But it fits the this little axe nicely, and it's a different way to make a sheet on, and I like that very much. The handle is made from ash tree and is 13 inch in length, and the head is made of some steel. I don't know what kind of steel it is, because they don't have that on their website. But the hardness is 54 to 56 on the Rockwell scale. And the head alone weighs half a kilo, 500 grams. And I think it's a cool little axe. I don't know how durable it is. I will test it in my coming videos and see how much work I can do with this. I'm pretty sure that it's great for carving when I'm going to carve something, but can it also split woods? Well, we'll see. Anyhow, I think it's a cool little axe, a little Viking axe. I like the handle, the shape of the handle very much, and this little head, I think it's very nice too. So in the future, I will bring this little axe with me when I'm out and preparing my camp.
Well, folks, this was all for now. Thank you for watching Kimber Bushcrafts. I hope you enjoyed this little video with my little story about this awesome little axe. It is not the video that I had planned to do because of the weather. I hope next weekend it will be better, so I can come out to my base camp and start preparing it. And before I go, I want to show you some other footage, drone footage that I took when I was out driving, and it's from down to the fjord, the water, and it's a very nice area. I've been there many times before, and when it gets summer, I'll do it again with my drone, because there's a very interesting story about that area. It's called Ertebølle here in Denmark. Well, I hope you're having a nice Sunday, and I hope to see you again on the next one. Bye-bye, and take care.